हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ प्रवीण कुमार। माय टॉपिक इज़ फ्लो आर्किटेक्चर्स फॉर ग्राउंड कपल्ड हीट पंप्स। ए ग्राउंड कपल्ड हीट एक्सचेंजर इज एन अंडरग्राउंड हीट एक्सचेंजर दैट कैन कैप्चर हीट फ्रॉम एंड और डिसिपेट हीट टू द ग्राउंड। सो दे यूज द एयर्स नियर कॉन्स्टेंट सबटेरियन temperature to warm or cool air or other fluids for residential, agriculture, industrial uses. If building air is blown through the heat exchanger for heat recovery ventilation, they are called earth tubes, Canadian well, provincial well, solar chimney, also termed earth cooling tubes, earth warming tubes, earth air heat exchangers, air to soil heat exchanger, earth channels, earth canals, earth air tunnel systems, ground tube heat exchangers, hypocausts, subsoil heat exchangers, thermal labyrinths, underground air pipes and others. So the air tubes are often a viable and economical alternative or supplement to conventional central heating on air conditioning systems, since there are no compressor, chemicals or burners and only blowers are required to move the air. These are used for either partial or full cooling and or heating of facility ventilation air. Their use can help buildings meet passive house standards or LEED certification. So this is the picture for groundwater is and a Quonset and wind catcher used as an earth duct for both earth coupling and evaporating cooling. No fan is needed. The suction in the lee of the window draws the air up and out. So this is the picture you have observed. This is the Quonset access shaft, cool basement, wind tower. So now the earth air heat exchangers have been used in agriculture facilities and animal buildings and horticulture facilities, greenhouses in the United States of America over the past several decades, and have been used in the conjunction with solar chimneys. In conjunction with solar chimneys in hot arid areas for thousands of years. Probably beginning in the Persian Empire, implementation of these systems in India as well as in the cooler climates of Australia, Denmark and Germany to preheat the air for home ventilation systems has become fairly common since the mid-1990s and is slowly being adopted in Northern America. Ground coupled heat exchanger may also use water or antifreeze as a heat transfer fluid, often in conjunction with a geothermal heat pump. See, for example, downhole heat exchangers. The rest of this article deals primarily with earth air heat exchangers or earth tubes. Passive design. The passive design ground coupled heat exchange is a common traditional technique. It drives circulation using pressure differences caused by wind, rain and buoyancy. Drive convention from selectively engineering areas of solar heating and evaporative radiative or conductive cooling. Formal research indicates that earth air heat exchangers reduce building ventilation, air pollution. Rabindra 2004 states the journal earth air heat exchangers is found not to support the growth of bacteria and fungi. So rather it is found to reduce the quantity of bacteria and fungi, thus making the air safer for humans to inhale. It is therefore clear that the use of earth air channel not only helps save the energy but also helps reduce the air pollution. So this is the design. Solar thermal coil optional and solar super insulation. This is the ground heat exchanger ventilation system with heat recovery and triple pan double lower glazing. This is the figure I have observed here. There are three configurations. There are three configurations: a closed loop design, an open pressure system, or a combination. The first one is closed loop system. Air from inside the home or structure is blown through a U-shaped loop of typical 30 to 150 meters, where it is moderated to near earth temperature before returning to be disturbed via ductwork throughout the home or structure. The closed loop system can be more effective cooling the air during air temperature extremes than an open system, since it cools and recools the same air. And the second one is the open system. Outside air is drawn from a filtered air intake. Minimum efficiency reporting value, MERV 8 plus air filter, is recommended. To cool or preheat the air, the tubes are typically 30 meters, 98 feet long straight tubes into the home. An open system combined with energy recovery ventilation can be early as efficient 8 to 95% has a closed loop and ensures that entering fresh air is filtered and tempered. And the third one is combination systems. This can be constructed with dampers that allow either closed or open operation, depending on fresh air ventilation requirements. Such a design, even in closed loop mode, could draw a quantity of fresh air when an air pressure drop is created by a solar chimney, clothes dryer, fireplace, kitchen or bathroom exhaust. It is better to draw in filtered passive cooling tube air than unconditioned outside. And the thermal labyrinths. A thermal labyrinth perform the same function as an earth tube, but they are usually formed from a larger volume rectilinear space, sometimes incorporated into building basements or underground floors, and which are in turn divided by numerous internal walls to form a labyrinthine air path. Maximizing the length of the air path ensures a better heat transfer effect. The construction of the labyrinth walls, floors, and dividing walls is normally of high thermal mass cast concrete and concrete block, with the exterior walls and floors in direct contact with the surrounding earth. Water to earth. An alternative to the earth to air heat exchanger is the water to earth heat exchanger. This is typically similar to a geothermal heat pump tubing embedded horizontal in the soil, or could be a vertical sump to a similar depth of the earth air heat exchanger. It uses approximately double the length of pipe, 35 millimeters diameter, example around 80 meters compared to an EHX of 40 meters. A heat exchanger coil is placed before the air inlet of the heat recovery ventilator. Typically, a brine liquid is used as heat exchanger fluid. Many European installations are now using this setup due to the ease of installation. No fall or drainage point is requirement, and it is safe because of the reduced risk from mold. This is the diagram. Heat pump, shallow heat collections. Plan views of shallow heat collection types. Serpentine coils, geometrical baskets, geothermal pile cross sections. And here they are given four diagrams, A, B, C, D. This is the closed loop slinky, and this is the closed loop lake pond, and this is the open loop. Thank you.